All right, y'all, welcome back to some more Horizon Forbidden West. So we gotta meet Telda upstairs. So if you're new to the channel, like and subscribe, and yeah, let's go meet her.
What is this?
Just a few favorites from my collection. Rescued and stored here just before I went off world. Take a look, if you like.
I'm gonna look at it later, the paintings.
There you are. Feeling better?
How did you find us? At the cauldron? And what did you do to everyone right before I passed out?
All business, I see. Well, suffice it to say we were keeping a very close eye on Hephaestus, knowing we would need it at some point. Your ruse didn't fool us, and as for my little trick, it was an overload of the senses, accompanied by an energy discharge. Gerard and Eric were only momentarily disoriented due to their shields, but it rendered you unconscious while I got you out. Perhaps some breakfast might steady you a bit?
This was your house. The one you recreated for Beta. In the data channel you shared.
How perceptive of you. Please, this way.
After everything your people have done, you think I'm just gonna sit down and have a chat with you?
They're not my people. They never were, and especially not now.
You shot off into space with them, and live with them for 1,000 years. Before coming back. So what made you suddenly turn on them?
Quite simply, this.
My old focus. You repaired it? But that means you've seen
incredible things. What you've accomplished in 2 decades of life. Thousand years at my back, and I haven't even come close. I'm sorry if I invaded your privacy, but I had to. In order to understand, to be enlightened. You truly are Elizabeth's blood. With her drive, her sense of mission, her integrity. Watching all this shamed me for the company that I've kept. Having seen it, all I want is to help you.
Even if it means stopping your friends?
Especially so. Please, sit down. There. That's better. Now, we must recover Beta and Gaia at all costs. By now, you must know that Gerard intends to use Gaia to reboot the Earth's biosphere. Remaking this world to specifications that would only suit us immortals. This process will kill every living thing on the planet. He calls it a clean install.
Not if I stop him first.
Not if we do. And once he and the others are gone, we can work together to fulfill Elizabeth's dream. I'm sure Beta told you that there's a build of the Apollo database on board our ship. A complete collection of human knowledge. With that and Gaia, we could do everything Elizabeth wanted. Heal the biosphere, educate the people of this world, uplift them. create the world she imagined.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. From what I've seen, your friends are invincible.
I do wish you would stop calling them my friends. And they're not invincible. In fact, a friend of yours has found a way to defeat them.
Silence.
Oh, he's been a busy bee, building an army powerful enough to crash through Gerard's precious base.
Regala and her rebels.
Even now, she's preparing a final march on the Tanakh capital. When she wins, she'll have the entire tribe under her control. Hundreds of warriors and machines to throw at the base. She's been duped. They'll all perish, of course. But it should be enough to break Gerard's defenses and allow Silence to kill him. Along with all the others.
Using the new weapon he's developed.
Yes, he's found a way to circumvent our shields. Truly an exceptional man. He's planned for everything. Except you and me. You see, while his army is battering down Gerard's doors, you and I will sneak in through a back way, one that only I know about, while Silence and my friends are busy battling each other. We'll take back Beta and Gaia. I told you I want to help you. I mean it.
First Varl, now Hikaru and the Tanakh. Your plan would wipe out an entire tribe. There has to be another way.
We are in an admittedly desperate situation, but I assure you there isn't. Remember Zero Dawn. Elizabeth's sacrifice. Sometimes many have to die for a new world to grow.
If it looks impossible, look deeper. Wait. The data channel. It still exists, doesn't it? I need you to open it. Let me talk to Beta.
Impossible. We might be detected.
It's worth the risk. There is another way, one where the Tanakh survive.
But we won't. If the others...
If you want to help, open it. What are they doing to her?
Virtual reality dissociation. The manual merge of Hephaestus will take hours upon hours of tedious micromanagement. If she resists the work, they run simulations to induce feelings of isolation and despair.
Beta, can you hear me?
They're watching me. I can't hold up this extra projection for long. You should have killed me.
No. No, look at me. I'm coming for you. I promise. Okay? I just need you to hold out a little while longer and work on the merge. Contact again when it's time. Can you hold on?
As long as I know you're coming for me, I can endure anything.
right. I did as you asked. Now I think you need to tell me what you're planning.
I'm going to take Sylon's army away. I don't need it. Only the weapon he made to penetrate your shields.
And how do you propose to get it? Ask him nicely?
Without Regala and her rebels, he won't have a choice. We'll be his only option.
Only option for what? What did you tell her?
That is between me and my sister. We'll be Sylon's only option for crashing that base. I'll tell you the rest later. But first, there are a couple of things I have to do.
Oh. And what are those?
Lay my friend to rest. And then I'm going to use the override that Beta gave me at Gemini to put an end to Regala's rebellion. From the air.
Wait. Since you insist on doing things your way, I know of something that will truly help you make a grand entrance with the Tenakt. The ancient Horus Titans still possess electromagnetic energy cells as part of their arsenal. Drop one of those on Regala's army and they'll receive quite a surprise. So go, do what you must. I'll come to your base if you manage to bring silence to the table.
Not if. When. Erend, are you there?
Aloy! Aloy, is that really you?
Yeah, it's me. Where's everyone else?
We're all... We're back at base. What happened?
It might be easier to explain in person. I'll try to join you there when I can.
Okay. We'll wait here for you. It's good to hear your voice, Aloy.
Man, I still can't believe Varel died, man. I can't believe it, man. I'm super sad right now. It's not even funny. Because I like Varel. He's a cool guy. Alright, let me return. Let me fast travel. So sad, man.
Just to let you know, I'm now patched into your focus network.
Great. I take it the other Xenos can't hear us?
Of course not. And they don't know about your base either, in case you were wondering. I've sent you data on the Horus energy cells you can use against Regala's forces. Reach out to me when you're ready to acquire one.
Understood.
When you're wounded, you have to strike back. Draw blood.
Hey! Can I get one damn minute to mourn my friend?
Regala is going to slaughter my tribe to overthrow Hikaru. The Zeniths have Beta and Gaia. We can't sit around wallowing in our losses.
Katalo's right. We must fight.
Oh, all right. So what are we gonna do, huh? Take on all of Regala's rebels?
Not to mention the Zeniths. What can we even do? Throw ourselves at their base?
Something like that. So...
After we lost contact with you, we regrouped and went to Gemini. What happened? The recording we found on Varl's focus cut off when that Zenith Eric...
The Zeniths were tracking Hephaestus. When Gaia trapped it in Gemini, they knew where we were. After Varl tried to stop them. They took Beta and Gaia. I only survived because one of the Zeniths turned against the others to save me.
One of them? Well... At least we didn't lose you, too. So what do we do now?
We're going to defeat the Zeniths. And get Beta and Gaia back. But first, we're going to stop Regala.
How?
Back in Gemini, Beta gave me a gift. There's something I need to do first to make it work, but it could put an end to the bloodshed.
Word is, Regala's readying her army for an all-out assault on the Grove. I need to be there.
I know. Go. Stand with Hikaru. And keep an eye on the sky.
Strike true as the Ten.
The rest of you, whatever preparations you need to make, upgrades, resupplies, get on it. It won't be long before we take the fight to the Zenith.
We'll be ready, Aloy. And when you're ready, meet me outside the east exit. I'd like to have a word in private.
Even when things are darkest, you're the flame that lights the way forward.
Just tell me one thing. Am I gonna get to smash up a bunch of Zenith bastards?
We all are.
Good.
Before I do anything else, I should check on Zoe. It sounded important.
Let's go see Zoe real quick. Zo, where are you? Outside.
Keep moving, keep warm.
Oh, there she is.
Over here, Aloy. We would come out here to tend to the garden. Sometimes I needed fresh air. Other times we would simply sit and watch the sunrise. So when we returned from Gemini, it seemed fitting that he be laid to rest here. Now he can always look out at Plainsong, and further east, to the Nora Sacred Lands.
He would have liked that.
He often spoke of his sister, Bala. He said she used to gather her favorite golden blooms and tie them to her spear. Their mother called it useless, but Bala was stubborn.
Yeah, she seemed like that.
It wasn't easy, but I tracked down the flower, gathered its seeds.
As verdant limbs wither, roots rot in snow, still the sea rises as certain as stone.
From death follows new life. So it is with the land. And so it is with us. I'm with child, Aloy. I was going to tell him when he got back from Gemini. Instead, one day, I'll bring our child here. We'll sit among the blooms and watch the sunrise.
I never got to tell him. To thank him. For saving my life, sure, but also for not giving up on me.
He always knew. Farl. I promise to look after them. Try to visit again when I can. But for now, I need to go to the fabrication terminal to install the new override on my spear. Then I'll use it on a Sunwing and get ready for an entrance Regala will never forget.